Good morning. It's December 24th, Christmas Eve. Ernest is still in bed. It's about 9:30. I just have to get up, do some errands before I trek on down to Newburgh, to my mom's house. We're going to have dinner tonight and then Christmas dinner tomorrow at my cousin's house. As I said, it's 64 degrees. My errands are all done. I'm packed up in the car here. I'm going to be heading off to Newburgh, and like I said, it's got to be almost 70 degrees by now. It was 65 or 66 when I was driving around earlier, but I mean, I've just got a sweatshirt on, and I'm warm. It's just really weird. It's nice, though. Not complaining. Anything's better than what we went through last winter. Crazy, crazy snow. It was just like never ending. Although there's people that have a white Christmas, we will not. And I don't care. So, I just got on the highway, and thank goodness there's not a huge amount of traffic, but then I'm suddenly starving, and I remembered, oh, I didn't eat this morning, so had to stop at the rest stop. Of course, you know, it's a fortune for anything that's normal, but I'm gonna get some Roy Rogers real quick and get something to drink and eat because I've got another hour to go, so got to eat my food and get back on the road. Mom. There's Mom. She was just about to go to Christmas Eve Mass. She's just going to go off to Mass. I'm not going to go with her. And then we're going to go out to dinner tonight. So we still have the tree with Dad's ornaments. All of Dad's handmade ornaments. Handmade ornaments. Here's one of the eggs that he did. Here's another one. It's a frosty. And it just amazed me how much time and effort and love he put into that. And it was just something that gave him pleasure because he would make the ornaments and then people would say, oh, those are really pretty. And he'd say, here, take one, take your pick. And he would never take money from anybody. He wouldn't even do it for, he wouldn't even set up at a craft show. I tried to get him a couple times to say, you know, just go when the mall has a craft show or, you know, wherever they could go, a senior center or something like that. And he's like, no, I'm not selling them. I don't want money for them. I'll give them to people if they want them, but I don't want money for them. Good morning. Merry Christmas. It's Christmas morning and we are opening gifts.
Oh, what a nice... Oh, it's on the other side. Oh, my Get Started Complexion Kit. That's why she kept stalling. I kept saying to her, you got to show me how to do that with the powdery stuff for my makeup. Yeah, okay, okay. And she kept stalling. Just because I'm 83 doesn't mean I have to look it, right? It
took her years just to do nail polish, for God's sake, much less do any major makeup stuff. But then, so then we're here at my cousin, Mike and Yolanda, and Austin, and just going to have Christmas dinner, and my hair looks weird, but anyway. Now nobody, it was just the two of you there
in the dish room, yeah, just the two of us in the dish room.
And then were pies left over and just sampled everyone.
When the pies were left on Friday, because there was no night shift down there, we had to throw them away. So we would take a bite out of every piece.
That was my Christmas day at my cousin's house. Not the most eventful, but I had a great time. They're really good people. My aunt, she's getting a little old. Sometimes she just randomly says things, or she knows what she's saying, because in her head, she already started the conversation and hears something in the conversation, although she can't hear really well. And things it has to do with that. And she'll just start a story like where it left off in her head. Or, you know, she's always been that way. So it has nothing to do with age. It's just her. Mike and Yolanda and Austin are awesome. And I love them dearly. And I don't know what I would do if I had a holiday where I couldn't spend at least some of the time with them. And anyway, so we're back home. I'm pooped. Probably going to have another cup of coffee and maybe some cookies or something. Then just gonna hit the hay. So there you go.
We're leaving each other. Live separate lives, finally. Actually, he forgot his coat. He said it's too cold, so Vlogmas is over. Yes! It's not that I didn't like it. It's a lot. Not just to film yourself every day, which is what we do anyway, but to actually edit it and put it up every day for the next day is a lot of work. I'm glad we're back to regular vlogging, so I'll probably do it again next year, but we'll see. My back is really hurting today. I got in a hot shower, took some Advil, and now I'm just trying to move gingerly along as not to hurt myself too much, but it's still a little stiff. It'll work itself out, I think. We are going to go get something to eat. We're both hungry. It's 1 o'clock. I got a package from Cassandra today. I'm actually not going to show in the vlog because I think I'm sending her a box. We're both going to video ourselves putting the box together, and then we're both going to video ourselves doing an unboxing, and I think I'm going to edit them together or do like a two-part video or something. So you won't get to see what's in Cassandra's box right off. But we haven't opened Christmas presents today. So Brian and I are going to be doing that when we get back home. I told Brian not to go shopping for me, and I bet he did.
Nope.
I bet you did, because why else would you keep me out of your closet? I thought about that this morning. Like, something's going on in there that he doesn't want me to see. My nose looks really red today, but I had a couple breakouts. I did a kind of a hard scrub on it earlier, so that's probably why it's red. Hey. And the boys come running. So it's Christmas time in the city. You can open your stocking first. Ooh, what is it? Show everybody.
It's a bag from Lush.
Lush.
It's balls.
It's a bath bomb.
It's a bath ball.
It's a bath Death Star.
Death Star, is that what it is? Makes my nose itchy.
I think that one was a vanilla one.
Yeah, this is the vanilla.
Oh, that's the vanilla.
Holy crap, that's like a moose ball.
Oh, yeah, it's huge, isn't it?
Oh, my, Archie, your balls are so big.
I think the small one is the vanilla one, actually. The big one's just got different sensors.
That one smells like a fabric sock.
But basically, they're just huge.
Oh, maybe it is.
The huge things you put in a warm bath, and they fizzle and dissolve. You have to read the card, because all the cards have something to do with the present, the gift tags.
Because you are my friend, Mr. E.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to say, did you do the wrapping, but it's just Bo's.
No, I let Amazon do it.
Bobo.
Bobo.
Bobo, are you here? It's Star Trek Into Darkness, which I don't have yet. You do, but I don't.
And then you have Star Trek, and I don't have that, so...
Oh, I thought you had it.
No, I don't. No, let's try it. Oh, I got nuts. Nuts. Mmm, scratch-offs. Can't go wrong with scratch-offs.
Yeah, especially if there's a bundle in one of them. Mm-hmm. Then we share.
Mm-hmm. A Target gift card. I told you not to buy anything.
I could not get you something.
You could just get me one thing. No. I would have been happy with the scratch-off and the nuts.
Because I love you.
Mm-hmm. Hard candy, awesome reds. Ooh. Cherry, strawberry, watermelon, and fruit punch.
Wait a minute.
Two It's a Wonderful Life scratch-offs, and three Holiday Treasures. You know, we just bought these.
I know, but you run out of them so quickly.
Scrubby.
And wait, to go with that, because you've worn out all your cloths that you're using for your washing your face, I guess.
Are you saying I should be on the rag?
Yes, you should.
Burt's Bees Energizing Body Wash. Grapefruit and ginger.
And now you can throw out all the old yucky ones. Is it a laser disc? Good grief. I'm green with envy over this one.
The other one is, that's what Spock says to Kirk, because you are my friend. It's the Charlie Brown Christmas album on green vinyl.
Yes. Pull out my big one.
Yeah, I've seen it.
It's like a chair.
It's a very big gift. I'm eating candy, sitting over here, fat ass eating candy.
I love this wrapping. I hope you can sink your teeth into this one. Oh, it's a drawstring. I just got that. Oh no!
Terry's like, oh, you're big fat ass on camera. Screw you, girl!
And I was just yelling at my mother again for this.
Oh my God, that's all he's talked about.
Mother threw my water pick out when I moved out of the house years ago. And I've never let her live it down. And she's like, well, I just thought, I wasn't sure what it was, and I didn't think it was important, so I just threw it out with the rest of the stuff.
Well, that's a deluxe one. It's got toothbrushes with it, too.
Love it. Love it, love it, love it.
I love it, I love it, I love it! Water pick. It's a water flosser and sonic toothbrush. Complete care. Oh, Terry says, hi, Brian.
Hi, Terry. Love you, honey.
I don't want to
be
seen on
camera. She got scared because I was grabbing her. She says, Merry Christmas. It's soaking.
Anybody want me to water pick on camera?
Hi. Show them what you got from your mom.
Oh, yeah, we got... Power XL pressure cooker, which you can cook, you know, anything in like 3 seconds. So, of course, mom shops the way I do. One for me, one for you.
So we can see. This is our tree for you streaming people. It's actually champagne. It looks really white on camera, but it's actually a 7.5-foot champagne colored tree. I didn't decorate
it. It always looks pretty, though, with or without decorations.
It was a $200 tree, and we kept going back. Looking for it on sale, and we got it when it was 90% off. We got it for $20. So,
well, I actually bought it once because it was 70% off, and I went and got one because I was afraid they were going to be gone. And then our neighbor went a few days later, and she said everything's 90% off, and the
tree
is still
there. That's what it was. They bought it.
So she grabbed it. I returned mine, and then I just paid the $19.95 for it. All righty, then. Well.
That's Christmas. Whole 15 minutes worth. I know Terry's over there talking some shit.